here at York University. My name is Zach Semeth alongside Matt Brown again after yesterday's first little alumni versus the top fundraisers. We have the championship game between the two top fundraising teams, Team Chaos in the white or green jerseys, I apologize, and the Jerry Hattricks in the white jerseys. Matt Brown, how are you today?
Fantastic.
Bit of a late introduction for you, I apologize.
That's all right. You do such a great job. I don't want to interrupt.
Thank you very much.
Interrupt you, but we should be in for a great game. And really, it's not about the game today. It's going to be about having fun, and it's all about this great fundraiser that they've had. We know Gordie Howe is a major part of this. The Gordie and Colleen Howe Foundation is a part of it for Alzheimer's. And it's going to be great. We have some great legends here. Gary Lehman. Guy Lafleur
is here, one of the greatest of all time.
Lanny McDonald's back for another round of some of his shenanigans, I'm sure.
Shenanigans, I believe, is the perfect way to announce how Lanny McDonald played last man's game. But yes, the two top fundraising teams were Team Chaos in the green jerseys, the Jerry Hattricks in the white. They raised together over $300,000 for the Gordie and Colleen Foundation. In total, so far this weekend, they have raised over $2.6 million for Alzheimer's research. Just a fantastic number for such a fantastic cause. We are moments away from the first drop puck with our guest referee, Steve Hutchinson, who will also be Dave Hutchinson, I apologize. Steve Hutchinson, I believe, is someone I know from my past. I kind of get those names mixed up sometimes.
It's okay. It's allowed. 2.6 million, Zach. What a number.
What a number. Let's just go back to that part. I didn't screw up that number. Just names.
Wonderful to hear that. Mm-hmm. And we've got a couple great Toronto Maple Leafs out here, of course. Doug Gilmore and Wendell Clark. So all those Leaf fans.
Don't forget Steve Thomas. He's out here, too.
Steve Thomas. Gary Lehman, of course.
Lehman gives it down to number 19. He brings it up on the left side, and Gilmore will pick it up, seeing his first action in the big alumni game. Him and Wendell Clark have a little couple words together as they run into each other. Looks like Gilmore's dogging it out there.
Never except when he gets up against Wendell. That's when the real battles happen.
That's when they'll start fighting for the puck. Lehman cross ice to number 19. That's intercepted by Lanny McDonald. Number 12 on the right side. He drops it down to 44. Shoots it in, tries to tip in, but that is tipped away by the Hattricks. And there's Todd Harvey bringing it out to find Lanny McDonald. Over the blue line to try and find one of his teammates. But nothing. They're going for a change.
Lanny taking his sweet time on that
sweet
one.
Sweet time. There's Jim Go over the blue line. Trying to find him. They try to center it. Gets it. They have a stick on it. That goes to the corner. Hattricks, nice little scoring chance for him. Attempted big hit by number 7 on Team Chaos.
Getting physical already.
Alright, gonna be a lot of physical play in this game, I'm sure not. Todd Warner on the bench looking like he wants to play the puck from there.
That was Gary Lehman.
What did I say?
Todd Warner.
Did I say Todd Warner? I said Gary Lehman.
So early
in the morning,
the
I haven't had my coffee yet. I apologize. The good people listening on SSNCanada.ca.
Mark Napier, who was a part of our alumni game yesterday, he's out there now, the two-time Stanley Cup champion with the Montreal Canadiens and Edmonton Oilers, a former 40-goal scorer as well.
Playing without the old helmet bucket. Nice little hat on him.
This hat's his helmet today.
His hat's his helmet. I don't think he's expecting to get punched in the head with him. But the Jerry Hattricks win a face-off. Todd Harvey, too busy talking with Rick Middleton. No.
Ron Flockhart.
Ron Flockhart.
Laurie Dupuis out on the ice, the 2002 gold medal winner with the Canadian women's national team.
Todd Harvey gives up to little Steve Thomas. Steve Thomas, one of the overtime heroes in Toronto Maple Leafs and Anaheim Duck lore.
Amazing to think that Steve Thomas doesn't have a Stanley Cup when you think of the all the amazing playoff runs that this guy's been a part of. He's one of the best postseason performers you'd ever watch.
17 on a partially breakaway. The Greenman, that scores it! That is a goal! 1-0 for Team Chaos early.
That's what happens when Tom Harvey starts playing defense like that.
tries to go on the wrong bench, he got pushed away for that one.
Rick Middleton out on the ice for the Chaos, former Boston Bruin.
Rick Middleton, Megan Sittler, Jason Zent, Gary Lehman, all on the ice there for Chaos.
Jason Zent, of course, spent some time with the Ottawa Senators, but really had a wonderful collegiate career at the University of Wisconsin, where he put up big numbers.
And we just missed Gingra knocked down Jason Zent in the defensive zone.
Good rivalry there. Former Montreal Canadian and Ottawa Senator colliding.
That's a bit of a rivalry there. I don't think Gingras ever played against the Senators, though.
Most likely not, no.
Gingra with the puck. Tries the center to give a slur. There's Jason Zent with the loose puck going down the left side. Trying to finds Lehman in the open net. He shoots over the net. Middleton banks it off the goaltender and in. Rick Middleton. Rick stuck in the Middleton with you, if you want to give him one of those funny nicknames that all these announcers are giving.
Rick Middleton, great Boston Bruin. You know, Zach, he's actually holds the Boston Bruin record for most points in a single season by a Boston Bruin, tied with Ken Hodge, who coincidentally was trading for him when Middleton was drafted by the Rangers, actually.
Oh, well, look at you. All a basket of information, Mr. Matt Brown. I will expect all that all day.
The basket's just gone open. Don't worry, Zach.
I believe Team Chaos has officially changed the name of the Green Machine. So says our Dave Hutchinson, the very vocal referee in this game. But after a brilliant save by the white team.
So Dave Hutchinson, the former Maple Leaf, doing a great job of officiating this game with his microphone.
He's getting names right, which is more than I could say so far in this game. Eddie McDonald behind the net. Someone falls down. Almost gets the puck back. From the 91 centers it. There's another shot. Is that in? Is that not in? We can't tell. That's in.
Well, if it's not, Lanny's going to argue it.
They're celebrating like it's in, but it's not. It looks like it's stuck in the pads. That is a no goal in the shutout for
Wendell Clark out there, the former Toronto Maple Leaf. First overall pick back in 1985.
One of the greats. Traded again for one of the greats, wasn't he?
He was. Traded for Matt Sundin, which is such a hard... You remember when that trade happened, Maple Leaf fans were devastated to trade away a guy that they loved so much, but what they got in return was another guy who did so much for that, so much for that franchise.
The face of that franchise for so many years. But he's not here, so let's talk about people who are here. Like Wendell Clark. There's Clark on the left side of number 12. He's wide open. Good defensive play there by the Jerry Hattricks. Number 77. They're getting the words of encouragement from Randy McDonald. Didn't shoot the work. He lost the puck to Mark Napier. Nice little stick movement there by Wendell Clark. 8-12 on a 2-on-1 for the Green Machine. Wendell Clark picks up the loose puck, trying to find an open man inside. The net is off, but no one really cares. They're going to keep playing. There's Gilmore. Harvey screaming in discouragement because McDonald couldn't get the loose puck.
It's not a good sign when you're yelling at your teammate already.
Doug Gilmore takes the puck away, and there's Todd Harvey. Rick Middleton playing little D. A sprawling goaltender for Team Green in a white jersey. Go figure.
They're just trying to mess with you, Zach. They're just trying to mess
with you. It's working. It's working hard. I am lost right now.
You sound just fine to me, don't worry.
I appreciate that. Rick Middleton will take the faceoff. He does not win. And Gilmer at the point shoots it in, tries to tip it past, but cannot get it by the goaltender.
Of course,
Gary Lehman trying to get the puck up.
Dougie Gilmore out here for the Jerry Hattricks. Doug's now coaching the OHL's Kingston Frontenacs.
Doing a pretty good job, too. Didn't make the playoffs, but, you know, he's a new coach at the young team. I saw them a couple times cover the Oshawa Generals this year, and they beat the Gens when I went to go see him, and they look pretty good doing it.
Yeah, and he's helped develop a couple good defensemen there. Eric Gubbertson, who's one of his D-men there, could be a high draft, first-round draft pick this season, and I'm sure he owes a lot of that to Dougie, who's done a great job over there in his hometown of Kingston.
Absolutely. Always has to do something good for your hometown. Here's the Green Machine trying to find the old man. There's Gary Lehman trying to center it, but that's broken up by the defense. Todd Harvey giving his goalie a little bit of encouragement there.
Dougie doing some cherry picking back here.
Lehman with the puck again. Finds Middleton. Couldn't find the puck. Now he does. And Megan Sittler tried to get it, but now Gilmore's got it. He finds number 7. Always nice to see the autographed jerseys out there. Saw a lot of them. I'm assuming in the bench or on the bench. There will be a lot of autographs given by the alumni to the fundraisers. There's Jason Benn. He finds Gary Lehman. He finds Megan Sittler. But she goes just wide.
Not showing the touch of bad high now. In his great career with the Leafs, the daughter of Daryl Sittler.
One on the right side. Goes off the stick of number 7. Now Lehman's got the loose puck. Finds Jason Zentz again. Tries to get by Zingrev, but he cannot do it. Number 91 centers it. There's Lehman again. He finds Zent wide open, but it's taken away. There's Flockhart. Finds Guillafeau on the breakaway. Guillafeau on the breakaway. Oh, what a save by the goaltender.
Well, I think that just went into that goaltender's highlight of his life.
Highlight of his life. He shakes his head. You can literally see the smile from all the way up here.
I think he's going to go home and apologize to the kids, but something just overtook their birth. That was us. That was robbing Guy Lafleur on a clear cut breakaway.
That is 2 saves on Guy Lafleur by the goaltender. Lafleur usually doesn't have this much trouble trying to score against the goaltender.
John Cherry probably could have used this guy back in his Boston days when Lafleur was beating him.
Oh, and off the crossbar. Still nothing going in. Jason Zent leads the rush out. It's a 3-on-1. Lafleur trying to get back on the defensive side. 44 in the corner trying to find Zent again. He finds him. Centers it. Tries to bank it off. Nothing to do it. 8:30 left here in the first period at the ice. The Canlan Ice Sports Arena for the Sports Day Storehouse for Alzheimer's. Bunch of alumni and contributors playing a nice game of shinny.
Thomas and Lafleur playing catch with the puck. Oh, Lafleur
really wants to get a goal on this defender.
Still got that competitive flair in it, man. 2 saves. That's enough for Lafleur, apparently.
Doug Gilmore playing a little defense from the bench. Now Steve Thomas with the open puck. Finds his man, but cannot get a stick on it. Jerry Hatchett looking for their first goal of the game. There's Todd Harvey.
Gary Lehman tricking Todd Harvey there. Wrong color jersey, but right on his tape either
and
way.
Lehman. Harvey trying to do the same thing. Sneaks it away. Harvey Lehman, a little bit of rivalry so far in this game. One LeClerc can't corral the puck. And then Lanny McDonald, former teammates.
Good Western boys as well.
Good old Western boys. Steve Thomas shoots, does not score. That goes wide of the net. Number 91 sends it down across the board. Todd Harvey picks it up, centers it. There's McDonald. Gets it over to 17. Cannot get the puck in. No shot taken. Number 77 at the point. Keeps it. Tries to be tipped in by Harvey with a goaltender with another great save. 91 centers it, but does not get through. One more Clark and Lady McDonald. One on one. Clark's got 4 teammates. It's a 4-on-1 if my math is correct. And that goes in. My math again correct. 3-0 now for Team Green.
You might be enrolling next year at a math program.
A mathematician. Right? I'm good at that whole arithmetic thing. It's 3-0 for Team Green.
And Wendell Clark setting up that third goal, not too shabby.
Not too shabby.
To go home tonight and say, yeah, my goal was pretty nice. Wendell Clark set me up for it.
He's going to work on Monday. Feel a little good about himself.
Yeah, had a good weekend. Scored a goal from a pass from Wendell Clark. I think I could live with that.
Beat all those fools who went to that Falwell Casino. All those commercials out there. You thought you had a special commercial at the casino. I got assist from Wendell Clark.
Yeah, I think the Pro-Am still should have tournaments.
Fallsview Casino, Fallsview Casino.
It's okay, you're not working for Fallsview, thank God. Right?
Well, I do love the good folks at Fallsview Casino. If they're listening right now, I could use a credit at your fine casino.
I'm going to pretend I didn't hear that plug, but...
Oh! Gilmore to number 17 to number 9, that's a goal. First goal for the Jerry Hatricks with 5:40 left in the first period. Good to get that first marker in. Avoid the goose egg. That would be embarrassing.
Well, the way Dougie and Wendell are playing so far today, the Leafs might meet these guys in the upcoming season.
Matt Brown used to play hockey when you were younger. I think the Leafs could use you this season.
I think, you know what, there might be a lot of guys in on this. I still
Brian Burke, if you're listening,
right,
I apologize. I don't mean to make fun of your team. Please don't hurt me. Back and forth, Ginger and Flockhart. There's 12 up the side there. Drops it off to number 9, looking for the open man. Centers it, no one there. Team Green trying to get it out. Ginger with a smile on his face takes it away.
Ginger's playing for keeps in here today. He's got some good legs on him still.
A big hit for 17, knocking down 12. There's Ginger looking for the open man. Loses the puck. Gonna get a little ribbing there from Middleton. Middleton and Jingle battling. A little Bruins-Canadians action there.
I'm sure those two had a couple battles back in their day.
There's Laurie Dupuis, a give and go with 77. Gary Lehman, Jingle a bit of a hit. Big save there by the goaltender. Stuck in the Middleton, throws it over. Number 17. We'll call him Steve Miller. Middleton stuck in the middle, Steve Miller band. I thought you might get the reference. Apparently you didn't. I'll stop trying.
Good fun, Zach.
Up the
good
middle.
Fun.
Number 7. Lehman playing defense. Tries to shoot it short side, does not get by the netminder. Gets the rebound. Oh, another goal by the Jerry Hatricks before the period is done. It is 3-2 for Team Green.
Making their comeback now. Todd Harvey on the ice for a goal, finally.
Let's talk strategy here in this alumni game. How big is it to get...
There's a lot of strategy in these charity
puck
events.
Puck movement. How big is it to get momentum going? Short side, stick side.
Well, I think I've seen Harvey over on the bench. He's been working up a couple plays, you know, get that F1 in deep, and then maybe sit on a lead if you're dark, you get the trap going.
The trap game going. Move Amarello behind the bench here.
Yeah.
Will we see a flying V at all, you think? Jason,
well, you know,
Zent.
If Steve
Megan
Thomas
Sindler
wants to, he could go back to his former days.
Megan Sindler regains the 2-goal lead for Team Green with a nice little goal. Reminiscent of the days of the silver medalist for Team USA.
I'm looking the other way.
Score the goal and take the faceoff. Sindler's going to take the faceoff with Guy Lafleur.
Dave Hutchinson having some fun grooving down there.
Todd Harvey gives it up to the left side. Number 7 trying to chase it down. Centers it to 4. Almost in the net off a couple of sticks there. It does not do it. Zent tips it by. Hutchinson calls no icing. We're going to keep on playing.
You know what? I don't think I've seen an icing call all weekend.
I don't think the clock stops with a goal.
It doesn't.
Megan Sindler gives it over to 19, who was calling for that puck hard. Centers it, but nothing happens. Zent, that looked like a hand pass to me. Come on, refs, let's call a real game here.
Hutchinson's too busy talking to call a penalty.
Number 4 on the right side. Helen reported to keep his head up. Don't admire his passes. Gary Lehman will knock you down if you do.
Yes, he's down yet. And the great Guy Lafleur out there.
Jason Zent cross-ice pass to his teammate, number 44. Finds Megan Sindler looking for his second marker of the night. Loses the puck, number 7. Now gives it up to Guy Lafleur. Guy Lafleur up to Doug Gilmore. Gilmore taken away from Zent. Zent's got a clear man up front. Gives it over to his right side to 44. To 3-on-2. But broken up.
Oh, and we have an appearance from Dale Hawerchuk.
Dale Hawerchuk, not here at the beginning of the game, has joined the Jerry Hattrick bench.
That's not too bad of an acquisition to grab Dale Hawerchuk, the former first overall pick.
With a minute left in the first period, getting his minutes in, getting his legs working. It's Cole Coffey making his first appearance for Team Green.
A couple of late additions. Can't complain with that. A couple of Hall of Famers come in late now.
Little stick movement there, trying to be a little fancy. Does not work. Zent taken away by Thomas. Thomas down the right side. He finds Doug Gilmore. Tries to find Doug Gilmore.
Uh-oh.
Too fast. Gilmore giving him a look. Thomas Tongue is sticking his puck out there. There's Wendell Clark on the breakaway. Dale Hawerchuk on his tail. Hawerchuk finds number 12. Tries to get a shot up. Cannot do it. What a save by number 12. Number 1.
Well, what kind of memories did that bring back, Zach, when you saw Paul Coffey pick up the puck and come around the net, wire a pass after those great Edmonton Oilers teams of the 80s? We saw Coffey do a lot of that.
Of course, I don't think he has Wayne Gretzky pass through on this team.
He doesn't. He doesn't. And Wendell Clark's not a bad substitute to send it up to.
Oh, a little bit of post-buzzer action between Steve Thomas and Paul Coffey. That's going to be a penalty ref. Please, call something for once. You're blowing this game.
Thomas making him pay for coming out late.
Well, that's the end of the first period. The Team Green has a 4-2 lead over the Jerry Hattrick. We're going to have a bit of a break here. A little shootout for a car. We'll be back with the second period right after this. Welcome back to the second period here at the Canlan Ice Sports Arena at York University for the Scotiabank Pro-Am for Alzheimer's game. During the intermission, we had someone from the audience try and win a Range Rover shooting from the far blue line into the other net in a little tiny puck-sized hole. He did not get it.
No one's driving home in a new Land Rover today, Zach.
Unless you buy one, of course. Some of the great people who sell Range Rovers or Land Rovers at your local car dealership.
I didn't know that you were the new salesman for everything.
I'm a salesman for everything. I just hope some executive is listening to this and will give me free stuff. That's pretty much what I'm hoping for.
Well, you know what? You're doing a better job than me so far because I haven't got anything free. But
you should sell your soul for free stuff. That's what I've been my intro since I was a young kid.
You know what? You gotta do what you gotta do, right?
Speaking of doing things, we have a hockey game on right now.
We do.
There seems to be a bit of a change in, like, you know, teams. Instead of the Jerry Hattricks, we have the Ice Ages playing in their spot. The alumni haven't changed, and the Team Chaos is now taking over for the Green Machine.
I was wondering, I was thinking, geez, they're really trying to mess with us.
Yeah.
Oh, Stevie Thomas.
Steve Thomas with a nice pass. Gets the goal. We're trying to figure out which team is associated with who now. And that is a goal for...
It was Lou Franceschetti that
Lou
actually
Franceschetti.
Got that. He's a new alumni.
A new alumni. Teams are changing. Players are changing. It's now 4-3. Franceschetti, quick interview on the ice with Dave Hutchinson. Remember when I said Steve Hutchinson earlier?
You did.
What I was thinking was Minnesota Vikings offensive lineman Steve Hutchinson.
I don't think he can skate.
No, I don't think so either. Then again, I don't think Dave Hutchinson can defend Brett Favre for 16 weeks of season.
No, you know what? I'm not going to put it past him.
So they both have their ups, they both have their downs.
Exactly.
Right,
but
Steve
one
Thomas,
up Delaney is
Thomas.
How great this tournament has been so far.
Absolutely. Franceschetti gives it over to Thomas in the slot. Thomas playing around with the puck. He finds Hawerchuk. He sends it to the end. There's some nice moves by the alumni. Ends with the Lanny McDonald goal. They were playing with the Chaos defense. Ties the game up at 4. Wow. There were some nice moves there. One of the cards is a smile on his face. You know, his team just got beat by a bunch of alumni playing with the puck.
All for good. Good fun.
All for good fun.
And Steve Thomas is looking pretty good out here. I'm sure that's why, like, St. Mike's Buzzers Junior A team has been doing so well the last couple years, seeing Steve is an assistant coach there.
There's Wendell Clark going down the left side. Cannot center it for one of his men. There's Laurie Dupuis coming up the left side, trying to find one of his teammates. No one there to help her. She's now taken out by 3 Team Chaos players. Dupuis, though, able to keep the puck in the The offensive zone playing around the corner, trying to find the open man. Still nobody. There's Rick Middleton with the puck. He finds his fellow defenseman.
Chaos not taking it easy on Lori Dupree.
No, they're going hard.
She can handle it, though. Gold medalist in the 2002 Olympics.
66 down the left side. Playing around with it, trying to find his open teammate. Cannot do it. A couple of sticks in the way of that pass.
Number 66, playing like a certain number 66 out there so far.
I have no idea who you're talking about. I have no idea who ever wore number 66 in the NHL.
I believe it's the guy that you try and pronounce his name with the X.
Oh, Mario Lemieux. Mario Lemieux, Super Mario.
Super Mario. And his Penguins are in a big matchup tonight against Guy Lafleur's old Montreal Canadiens.
I think a bigger matchup, of course, is the Ice Age versus Team Chaos.
Well, of course, right now, this is the biggest matchup ever.
As Guy Lafleur going behind the net. The referee, during play, trying to get the net back on. You only see that in charity games. There's Lafleur trying to find the open man. Sent it behind the boards, behind the net. Dupree open.
Now, behind the boards, that would be quite
impressive.
The play.
Why you're here to pick me up. But I'm Lux and you're the brains. Finds it is Megan Siller on a breakaway. And oh, what a great diving stop by the goaltender. That was the left pad, the right pad, left for me, right for him. Clark behind the bench to Zent. Under the leg pass by Wendell Clark to Jason Zent. That is a goal.
Was, a lot of defense on that goal. He was just trying to get out of the way.
Nice little goal to restore the lead for Team Chaos. It's 5-4. With 15 minutes left in the final and second period. Alum on the ice right now. Jason Zent, Megan Siller, and Paul Coffey for Chaos. Well, Todd Harvey, Doug Gilmore, and Dale Howardchuk for the Ice Ages.
Five Stanley Cup rings in on the ice between four Paul Coffey's and Doug Gilmore's one. Not too shabby, if you ask me.
Not too shabby at all. That's a whole hand. That's a nice goal by Harvey. Runs right into Coffey right when he does it. Goaltender, looks like he's a bit of a verbal tussle with a defenseman of his. Not sure why. Hasn't got up yet. Still sitting there. Still sitting there.
Getting some quality advice from Paul Coffey. Maybe he's telling Paul, pick up your game out there. Do something.
Paul's telling him, you're no Grant Fuhrer.
Well, I don't know if I'm going to that time,
Megan Sittler wins the draw over Doug Gilmore. There's Coffey skating around Gilmore, looking pretty good right there. Passed it up to him on the right side. Trying to find Zent, centered it, could not get it in. Bit of an awkward angle there. Coffey finds Zent, who finds Sittler in the slot. Tries to get it to one of her teams, but could not. Gilmore steals the puck. Here comes Ice Ages down the left side. Could not get the pass on. Sittler with the steal. We'll get it behind the net. But there's Harvey with the steal. He's got a wide open man in the slot, but that's another defensive play by Team Chaos. Paul Coffey looking up ice, finds Jason Zent. He tried it, trips. That would have been embarrassing. He would not have ever heard the end of that, falling in a charity game like that wide open.
No, I don't think he would have.
Zent tries to make amends for that one, keeping the puck inside for the Ice Ages, or for Chaos, I apologize. Chaos opened the slot, could not get a shot off Gilmore now with the puck. Around Zent, he finds former teammate Steve Thomas. He shoots over the net, could not get it in. There's Howardchuk in an awkward angle. That goes around the boards, right over Napier, over the blue line. They have to go back to defend it offsides. Jason Zent now has it after taking it. Zent looking for them, but good defensive play there. Able to take it away, but there's Napier keeping it in.
I say, Jeff. Putting up a little better fight than the Jerry Hattricks so far in the first period.
They may not be as old as the Jerry Hattricks. If you get my pun there, if you don't, I apologize. Mark Napier can't keep the puck on his stick, but there he is again. Gives it over the defenseman at the point. Told to shoot, instead passes. Zent centers it. But that goes through a few bodies stopped by the goaltender. There's a fallen defenseman there, but now wide open in front of the net. Could not get the puck. Good defensive play by Chaos. There's McDonald with the puck. over to Francis Getty, right back to McDonald, over to Flockhart. McDonald tries to get it in, but a save.
It's not too bad if you're number four in the ice age right now. You're on the ice with four NHL alumni players.
Just sort of sit back and watch them do well. There's Napier with the steal. Gives it up to 81. Napier cuts the pass off, going to try and keep it in the zone and be able to. But Lanny McDonald with the steal, trying to find an open man. He finds Flockhart. Flockhart and McDonald on Coffee and Middleton. McDonald shoots, but that's taken away from Middleton. Now Flockhart's got the puck. He throws it in center. Steve Thomas trying to battle for it. Does not get it, but six on chaos. Able to get it out. Nice little stick is there. Beats DeLaFleur with the puck. Now it's a 2-on-1. 81 wide open. Shoots. Canlan scores. That's a 5-hole goal. Gives Team Chaos the 6-5 lead.
Chaos.
Chaos.
Big lead. It's just, you might say, chaos in that end of the ice.
Out there. That is a little too obvious to say that, Brown. You're better than that.
I'm sorry. I couldn't help myself. It was there waiting. I just had to take the opportunity.
Worried if we get to take the faceoff against number 66 of Chaos. If Fleur can't get the puck, wasn't really looking. Gives it back to his defenseman. Gives it over to Howardchuk, right back to the Fleur. Over Coffee. Coffee to try and get it back. Middleton can't get the puck there. Chaos finds 21 open near the up. Now he's got Wendell Clark wide open. Gives it right back. 66 shot. What a! That go in. That hit the post. Nice little drop pass by Clark and a big shot by 66. But couldn't not get it in.
He's just showing a lot of that Mario Lemieux fool over in that number right there. Only if he could have done that for me when I played hockey. Maybe that was my problem. I didn't wear number 66.
No, you didn't. What number did you wear when you played hockey?
Without a different one.
What was your favorite number?
I think it was number 9, the same one that the great Gordie Howe wore.
Oh, of course. Not a bad one. My number is 55 for the great Rick Jackman of the Toronto Maple Leafs. Like,
really, I didn't know great was attached to Rick Jackman's name. But you know what? I'm not going to judge that.
Well, a little trivia for you. Rick Jackman, the only player in hockey history to win a Stanley Cup and a Spangler Cup in the same calendar year. There's Team Chaos. Oh, drops
amazing
it down the
clutch.
Amazing knowledge. Well, amazing. I know everything there is to know about Rick Jackman. Wendell Clark with the wide open shot does not take it. Instead, drops it off to a teammate. Clark tries to get the puck back. Could not. He has Coffee at the point. Coffee has been there before. Scored a lot of goals from that angle. Gives it to Middleton. Middleton falling while he passes. Pass picked off by Lori Dupuis. There's Howardchuk with the puck trying to find his opening. He finds an open woman. There's Lori Dupuis. Paul Coffee. Gives it back to Flockhart. Nice Coffee takes it away from the front of his netminder. Howardchuk sent it down the middle to Flockhart. To LaFleur. LaFleur's got an open shot, does not take it, gives it back to Howardchuk. Howardchuk shoots over the net. Dupuis gets the loose puck. Dupuis battling with Coffee for it, passes it up to LaFleur. LaFleur tips over! Fleur on the ground thanks to somebody tripping him down. That is dangerous. On the other side of the ice, 21 tries to do a sweet backhand, but an even sweeter save by the netminder.
Keila Fleur going down hard with...
Oh! What a way for that puck to go in! Tail Howardchuk with a 120-footer. He shoots it all the way down. The goalie cannot play it correctly. He bounces off the stick into the net. Howardchuk has never scored like that before.
Well, I think if you're the wannabe goalie down there, you're going to have trouble. That's
a embarrassing one. That is Vesna-Toskala-esque.
Good thing it's... And Hutchinson's poking fun at him now. And I don't think that'll be the end of that.
I think everybody's been poking fun at that one. That is the tying goal, 6-6 now. If that proves to be the turning point, that could be embarrassing for the netminder. But there's Siller with the goal right after, able to give the lead right back to Team Chaos.
But if you're ice age, I think maybe you just want to shoot from anywhere after the last one.
That goalie may not be able to get over that one, but Megan Siller able to get the lead right back to Chaos. 7-6 with 6:50 left in the final period. Sittler wins it, gives it back to the defenseman, who gives it right back to Sittler. He bounces it up, right back to Sittler. A give and go and give and go all the way. Zent and McDonald trying to get to the puck. McDonald ends up with it. He's got Warner on the run. He's got Harvey on the right. I said Warner again. I got Warner on the mind, but Harvey with the puck. Gives it McDonald, bounces off someone's stick. There's a great shot by Flockhart. Great save by the netminder. Haven't said that in a while.
No, we haven't. I haven't saved John Warner a lot. Good save. He rebounds from that disastrous goal he allowed in earlier. Big save on a former NHLer. Todd Harvey, Edmonton Oilers, San Jose Shark.
I think it's that first name Todd that keeps confusing me. T. Harvey.
T. T. Harvey.
Cross-ice pass. There's a breakaway for number 99. Wayne Gretzky cannot get it in. Nice save to keep the score at 7-6. Keep the one-goal deficit.
Well, no wonder Chaos is leading this game. They got a 66 and a 99 right there.
Chaos throws it up net. Gonna try for the long shot again. Let's see if this goalie can stop it. And he can. Little Bronx cheer for the netminder. Right back, everybody's There's the Bronx cheer. Not a very good pass, Landon McDonald right there. That's a big ball. He hits the boards hard, Landon McDonald. There's gonna be a hits the board hard. Landon McDonald apologizing profusely, but looks like he's okay. Hutchinson's calling for a penalty shot.
We've got our first penalty of the tournament. Hutchinson finally doing some work out here.
Too busy talking, not calling.
But he's got a penalty shot now. Landon McDonald could cost his team big now.
Power Chuck and McDonald now calling for a dive. Hutchinson now asking the crowd. He scores! While Hutchinson was talking, we had a penalty shot that happened. He scored. It's 8-6 now for Chaos. Nice little move there by number 7, McDonald, giving a pat on the back. A little apology for that one. The crowd said it wasn't a dive, so he got his penalty shot and he scored.
Landon McDonald wearing the goat horns now.
Yes. Indeed he is. Gilmore wins. The face-off, him and Napier exchanging words at center ice. There's Howardchuk already with the goal of the year with his 120-footer. Number 81 taken away by Howardchuk. Throws it down, trying to find an empty man. There's Thomas behind the net now. A little stumpy. Finds Howardchuk now open in front of the slot. Looking Francis Geddes in front of the puck. He shoots it, but a nice save by the netminder. Now, Gilmore behind the net. Is this the St. Louis Blues all over again? He's going to try it. No, he won't. Instead, there's Hutchinson again. Hutchinson, number 23, the player. Not sure if there's any relation to the referee. Howardchuk steals the puck away. Finds Steve Thomas. Takes it over the side. He's got Gilmore, and he's got Howardchuk again. Howardchuk in the slot. Doesn't take the shot. Decides to pass it instead. Well, hold on to it, looking for the pass. He gives it over to Franceschi, but a nice save there by the netminder. It's 8-6 for Team Chaos with 3:25 left in the final period. Face-off on the left side of the Team Chaos goaltender. Alumni on the ice for Chaos. Wendell Clark, Ron Middleton and Paul Coffey, Flockhart, Thomas, and Lori Dupuyon for the Ice Agents. There's Clark again, trying to chase the puck. Goalie out to play it. Outside of the trapezoid that they usually is. Hutchinson and the other ref talking strategy, how they're going to call the rest of this game. Maybe they're pulling a Tim Donaghy or something. Coffey behind the net, gives it over to Wendell Clark, taking away there. Oh, Middleton fall, hits the boards hard. They're going to call a penalty? Middleton gets a penalty, draws a penalty. Of course, some people are going to call dive every time someone falls, and I think it's what we're going to do here.
You get the penalty shot right here.
Middleton dives, so the person who quote-unquote trips him will get the penalty shot. Try to make this a one-goal game.
Rick Middleton. Now he might be wearing the goat horns. Oh,
this is control of the puck and a save there by the goaltender. You know what could have helped there? The triple deke.
Triple deke. You know what? It's a shame Charlie Conway's not a part of this game.
Unfortunately. I say he's alum. He's greatest captain in the Junior Goodwill Games history.
The Junior Goodwill Games history. You betcha. And all banks in it.
As Tim Cass, long outlet pass there by Coffee.
Dougie pulling some tricks from the bench there.
Eva Fleur finds Louis to free wide open, going for the shot. Nice save there to keep the two-goal lead for Team Chaos. A minute 30 left, a minute 38 left in the final period. The clock will stop now with 2 minutes left to play. I guess under 2 minutes will stop, try and give the ice saves a little bit of a chance. Trying to do it. Steven Stamkos falling straight, but cannot do it. Team Chaos outlet pass. Another one of those 120 shots. 120 foot shots. Able to save it this time. One look. Clark forecheck. Gives it over to Middleton. The Flockhart, of course, to Dupuis. Trying to get behind Coffey. Coffey plays a good defense. Steven Flurry gets it right over to Dupuis. Dupuis gives it to number 21. 21 trying to find Manny McDonald behind the net on the corner.
And there is about 8 white players on the ice right now.
Is that a save?
That was a quick save.
What a glove save.
7 white players on the ice right now. Good thing Hutchinson's keeping track of
this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Too busy counting when he should be counting.
Singing a little lowrider. Alumni on the ice right now. Howard Chuck McDonald. Todd Harvey, Ron Flockhart. Great save there by the goaltender. I think we have another 7 people on the ice here.
Good to know they're not paying attention.
Number 4, number 21, Steve Thomas.
Oh, Doug
Gilmore. And there's a goal by Todd Harvey. Todd, don't call me Warner Harvey. I believe they're counting 2 goals on that one. Nope, it's back to 8-7. So 8-7 for Team Chaos over the Ice Ages. 49 seconds left here in the Alumni Championship game. Megan Sittler wins the draw, gives it down to a defenseman, Flockhart, trying to play a little defense with the empty net. Chaos again. Napier playing a little, hurting his team on that one. Coffee with the puck off the rebound. Flips it up, hits the rafters, falls down.
He planned that one, I'm sure.
Yeah. I can only assume he meant to kill time on that one. Harachuk able to save it from getting into the net. He finds Gilmore. Best efforts by Navy to keep it away. Paul Coffey. Give it over to Jason Zent. Zent over to Megan Sittler. Over to number 99. Back to Sittler. Shoots. Scores. That is what we call the hammer in the coffin. Hammer nails coffin. That is the end of the game.
Hammer in the coffin.
You don't put hammers in your coffin? I don't know what you're doing with your coffin anymore. But that is it. 9-7 for Team Chaos. They win the championship game here at the Canlan Ice Sports Arena at York University. Championship game over.
And it's only fitting the top fundraising team captures the championship.
Absolutely. Spend the most money. Help for Alzheimer's research here at Sportsman Program 4. Alzheimer's Research. That'll do it for me and Matt Brown. I'm Zach Summers. Thank you so much for coming in and watching.